Doomslayer, Sarah. The Seraphim's key is close. I'll mark it on your HUD.
remember. Now, we work to resurrect the only ones who can save this world and its people.
Warning, the Seraphim's chamber key has been removed. The Slayer has the key. This facility will self-destruct in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Seraphim's body is in a secure location, 1,000 feet below the main deck. I've marked the best access point.
Something with this DLC, it's been much harder than the previous one. I think it's the fact that we just don't get a lot of extra lives. I think it's the fact that the AVs are still the same, but it's just without the extra lives, we're pretty screwed. There's that. There's a lot of things that are frustrating with this DLC. Part one, at least. It's very odd. Slayer has the biggest lodge to go through all that. Okay, so we gotta be at the end of the first level at least. Seriously, he can hold his breath. That's impressive. Is that a shark? Oh shoot, that's a shark.
The Seraphim was the loyal aid to the Father. You and every human on this planet owe your reality to them.
He's talking about the Father. Who is he? Trying to kill Bilico. What is that? In terms of part one, I'm not like too impressed, but I'm not disappointed. It's still same gory doom that I like. It just seems repetitive. Seems much frustrating because the extra lives is kind of very limited and diminished. It's like the golden ticket. It's like literally the golden ticket just to find the extra lives. Pretty harder this time around. I like the amount of health, but... I don't know, it's just... With the main campaign, it was more... I don't know. Something's missing in this one. Pretty much, if I didn't have like souped up max level or max level weapons, I'd be screwed. I'd be dying a lot often. And that was the thing about the main campaign. It looked like it was leading somewhere, and the pacing was pretty freaking cool in terms of that. Story could have been took a backseat, but the pacing was much better. This one, it just feels like we're kind of fiddling around until part two. Worry about the shark that I saw earlier. Oh, 2+ up. Yeah, that's gonna be useful. I desperately need it. I wonder how I get there though. That's some convenient water. Wait, what's going on?
The Seraphim's chamber is close by.
Okay, so the Seraphim, I'm kind of curious about it. Ah, shoot, I'm running out of oxygen. Much better. Going through all this underwater bullcrap. Really? You're gonna do this while I'm on the wall? Dickheads. That's so freaking unfair. In terms of variety, I do appreciate new turns. It changes up the strategy, which is... And I like the new locale. There's that. I mean, in terms of things I like, gameplay is still pitch perfect. The new locales, there's the new areas are... Yeah, it's kind of a great new addition to the Doom Eternal lore. And the... Just a turret. That's pretty much it. I don't think the enemy variety is groundbreaking. I'm not disappointed with this DLC. I'm just not I just feel like it's just passing the time.
The UAC has been in possession of the Seraphim since before your time. It is a relic from their past, the organization's most closely guarded secret.
Ooh, ominous. Now I'm very curious. Oh no, I'm not really blown away by the story this time.
Big freaking gun. Ammo.
Yep, that's a Mirage. Ooh, two of them. Yeah, this is gonna be intense. Oh, come on, man. Ah, shoot. Wait, you killed three Marauders. Let's dance, boys. Oh, crap. Killed your brother, bound to kill you. That's right. Oh, are you freaking for real? Oh my gosh. Oh, it's worse. Oh, I really miss my unlimited ammo and cheat codes. And that's why the main campaign was much stronger. Let's go. Chew on that. Really? I'm good. Not today. Not my intent, but I'll allow it. Rip and tear until it's done. Oh my gosh. Bruisers. actually pretty sick. Saved by the shield, dickhead. Why? Stay down, dickhead. Oh yeah. Lickety split.
Sounds fine.
That's fine, but pretty freaking tough. Well, not as when I first started. Oh, okay, so now we're definitely at the end. Oh, crap, this took so long.
He is the one who gave you your power. It was divine intervention. I am going to transfer my consciousness into the device as Vega did. I am here to help you, as I have always.
That's bullcrap. You screwed me over in the first game.
And now, they will fear you.
Ominous? Oh, wait, what's going on?
We have been allies for some time now.
Oh, you're gonna screw me. Yeah, he's just gonna know you.
He will save us all.
I like the lore on. That was actually interesting. That was actually interesting. Yeah, everything was just kind of repetitive. No, killing all the demons from hell in a gruesome way never gets old. But it just that they didn't add anything fresh or anything new, but the that kind of lore snippet, I kind of like that. The new areas are pretty unique. I actually like them. Plus, they had some new platforming that kind of changed it up, but nothing groundbreaking, but still good, still good. Okay, let's continue for a little bit. Oh, wow, 51 minutes. Okay, so we're only going to be able to do a little bit.
Dr. Hayden is the Seraphim. He's been with us the entire time.
I am sorry. There's no need
for... You need to see this, because he's not well. Something is happening, and nobody here knows what's wrong with him.
Well, we don't know yet.
You say that.
The Father's life sphere sits atop the Ingmar Sanctum, located in the blood swamps of hell. My body is undergoing rapid transfiguration. It is why I need the Father. Reach the tool and acquire the Father's life sphere. Bring him back into physical form. I will not be able to join you. Makers cannot set foot in the dark realm. I will be waiting for you at the Sanctum.
The Seraphim cannot retrieve the sphere. It's forbidden.
I have the Blood Swamp's location online.
Be grateful. Despite your transgressions, you are given the honor to serve the gods yet again.
Yeah, Doomslayer looks like he doesn't give a flying flip. Can I kill him? I feel like this is a foreshadow. We should kill him. Nope, can't kill him. Alright, looks like there's no collectibles. This is just the hub. I mean, it's not disappointing with this dude. This first part, it's just nothing spectacular. I'm not too impressed. I'm not disappointed. I'm just considering what I came from, like the main campaign in Doom 2016, I was kinda. Eh. Yeah, this is kinda lackluster. Plus, there's no Vega, so that kind of... that kind of makes it a little sour. Okay, this is another unique area. So it's hell, but it's green now. Okay.
I see your mission objective states that you're going to destroy the sphere, not retrieve it. That is not, sir, what Dr. Hayden, the Seraphim, has requested of us, you.
Enter. Shut the frick up. I'm gonna do what I want. He's Doomslayer. He can do whatever the heck he wants, and we roll with it. That's a stuff of nightmares. So wait, is this still hell, but not with a... about the flame, the fire, and brimstone. This is just basically also hell, but with swamp. I wonder what those are. Ah, those could do something. Hey guys. You sure know how to. Okay, poison swamp. Got it. That regrows. Alright, I miss. That's fine. Music's still fantastic for Doom Eternal. Even if it's a DLC, the music is fantastic. It's pretty hit finger. Yeah, this one's actually fits pretty well. back off. This is not your block one today.
What the?
I was not expecting that. Okay then. Okay, but we gotta actually quit because they're 50. We're past almost an hour. That giant tentacle, that changed it up. I actually appreciate that. That wouldn't surprise me. Like I said, the level design and the newer areas are actually uniquely well done. I kinda hope it carries over to part 2. So I get it, they're testing the waters with the story DLC. I don't think Doom's known for its story DLC. It's kinda weird. But yeah, that one kinda changed it up. I'm curious what they'll do with this one. Yeah, story's still just not great. I think it was much better in the Doom Eternal. Yeah, I think it was much better in Doom Eternal and Doom 2016 because there was less of it, and it just focused on Doom Slayer just being legendary status. This time, they're trying to actually put the story for fun, and it's not bad, it's just nothing groundbreaking. Okay, so guys, there will actually be more Doom Eternal coming out walkthrough. Yes, yes there is. And I'll let you know the schedule for the rest of it, but we're gonna move on to the random day that we have planned for Friday. And Saturday will kind of be a break, but I might do Doom Eternal again because I kind of want to continue it. Okay, so of course, stay tuned, leave a like, comment, leave a like, or subscribe, and stay tuned. I'll have a good ending slogan. And I'll do some ending speech that's, well better. Anyway.